time for our class. All right, before we get started with class, I'm going to... I was thinking about this yesterday, that there are a few sounds in the English language that aren't in Chinese. And there are a few sounds in the Chinese language that aren't in English. So we're going to start off just by going over the four sounds in each language that we don't... that the language has. So the other language doesn't have. So in English, the Chinese language doesn't have the TH sound. So this is just something to remember that when you're teaching your kids, this is something they'll have more trouble with, the TH sound. So they don't, because there's no sound in Chinese. There's also no sound, no V sound. So, and also Z, no Z. Now with I, there is, when I write down I, they have an I sound, but they don't have an I. There's no I in Chinese. Alright? So you'll find out that very few, that in order for Chinese, Taiwanese students to sit, there's very few Taiwanese students that can correctly say I, based on my observation. So these are the four sounds, phonetical sounds you really need to work on with your students. Now in Chinese, there's also four sounds that aren't in the English language. And I've talked to you about this one. Zi. Zi. It's like a Z sound, but like I said before, it has a D at the beginning. Like when I first started learning Chinese, I pretty much wrote my own phonetical system. I would write it as a D, Z-I sound. Zi. Alright, so you say zi. Zi. Alright. Okay, there's another sound right here. And it's a si. Si sound. When I write down, I write a T-S-I. It's like a T before S sound. So I say si. Si. So the first one, zi. Si. Okay, now these two sounds, it takes some practice, but for me, I don't think it takes too long to learn them. This, I think, is the most difficult one, the hardest one I've had. I don't know exactly how to write. I think how I wrote it, I write like as a J over an R and I, because I have no idea. It's a R sound. I want to have a native speaker say it, actually. R. Yeah, the sound. Okay. R. Yeah, it's like, okay. R. 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 Yeah. Thank you. Yes. So usually when I say it, I focus more on the R sound, but it's actually.
It's like
R.
Similar
to when you pronounce R, like an R rabbit, right? When you say, you are R, you're saying R, because the difference of the R sound. But we're saying
R. R. This is more native.
Another R was
a R, right?
So
yeah.
I
was
saying R. Yeah. Yeah. What I do is I close my teeth
and
my tongue
will touch
the top.
R.
So you
want to
do that?
No, the tongue is not touched the top.
Okay.
Okay, it's go back and a little bit, yeah, touch the back. Touch the back of your the back upper back of your here.
So this is something you need to practice a lot. Yeah. Actually, where I live in Kinmen, many people can't say this sound either. A little, they say more of a sound, more of an N sound. Alright, this is also a difficult one. It's like the French U sound. U. U. Yeah. Yes. Fish. Yeah, so you don't. U is fish. Alright, language, I think, is third tone. Right, yeah. U. That's language. All right? And then if you meet someone, you say "ü" or the tone. Yeah.
Rain.
Rain. Rain is third tone, right? Ü. Now, language too is also third tone, right?
Yeah.
Third tone, yeah. Yes. Ü, yes. All right. So, yeah. So these are the two sounds that are really hard to say in Chinese. Yeah, so those are the ones, yeah, practice on. Zhi, zhi, yu, yu. I want to have a native speaker say it. I don't want you to learn from my mistakes.
Oh, okay.
So,
yu.
Which one
is that?
Which one?
Okay. Zhi, zhi, yu. The phonetic symbols? Okay. So, for the phonetic symbol, this is z. Like a z. Zi actually is my family name. My family name is Zeng. So it starts with zi, zi, zi sound, zi sound. So this is zi, zi, zi. I think when you pronounce zi, your teeth together, zi, right? And the sound just like come out from your mouth, zi, zi. All right, and this one is, okay, zi, zi. Can you tell the differences? Okay, again, this is z. Okay, z. And this is c. Can you identify? All right, I will say, and then you point one or two. Okay, c. Right, z. Yeah, you guys are brave. Okay, z. Z. Z, yes. C, C, right. C, Z, Z, C, C, Z, 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 Z. Yes, great. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, that. Z, okay. Z, okay, Z, yeah, Z, yeah, Z. Yeah, it's now when you say like a sound, that's right? And this is this is like this is yeah, this is like so this is okay, sorry. For phonetic sound, you should be like and this is yu, 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 yu. And this is zi, zi. Alright, so do you want to try again? This is zi, 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 good. Yu, yeah, and this is yu, yu. Yes, this is back. This is yu.
Alright, thank you, Anna. Great job. Alright, so we're going to learn a phrase that we learned very briefly a couple days ago. This is du. Du means to wish. Wish. Ni. Ni. Oh, fourth tone, right? Alright. So, du. Du. Ni. Okay, what's ni? You. Sun. Sun. Okay, sun means light. Okay, ri. Ri. So, this is the sound. This is the sound that's really hard to learn. But then you have to go four times. Zhi. Zhi. Sun. Zhi. Okay? Means, this means birthday. Right here. Then, last one is? Right. Kuai.
Kuai.
Le. Kuai. Le.
Kuai. Le.
is happy. So what's this? What does it mean in English?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
Wish you.
Yes.
No, wish you happy.
Wish you birthday happy. Yes. So, since it's Van's birthday today, we will sing to her in Chinese. Now, in Chinese, when they sing happy birthday, they just sing happy birthday. They just say the sentence over and over again. They don't add the happy birthday, dear so-and-so. They just say happy birthday many times. All right, so let's practice again.
祝你生日快乐祝你生日快乐祝你生日快乐
All right, now let's sing together. Ready? 1, 2, 3, go.
祝你生日快乐
a good point, yes.
I know that, but when you say 我好累, in this kind of sentence, 好 actually means so. I mean, the connotation is more similar, mm-hmm. more near so. But when you say very good, 很好, the 好 is just means good.
Mm-hmm.
So 很好 is very, very good.
Yes.
How has many meanings?
Yes. All right, good. Let's or does anybody remember how to say hungry? Like you're hungry to death? Good job. Good. Like a UH sound. And you go fourth tone. Alright, how would you say I like pizza or I like hamburgers? Pizza, good. Okay.
Hanbao,
very good. Hanbao, yes, good. 我喜欢汉堡. Good. Alright. What else do you like? 我喜欢 what?
Pizza.
Okay, pizza is.
Okay, but don't say
我喜欢炒饭.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes, I do. Yeah,
Like Indian people, right? they cannot pronounce certain sounds in English, so it will sound really Taiwanese. Where is it that Taiwanese? So it's a go. This is go.
Yeah, also I noticed like with the F sound, some people, especially some of the older people, they can't say the sound. So like for coffee is, do you guys remember?
Cafe.
Cafe, they'll say cafe, they'll have an H sound there. Yeah, we all have cafe.
Beiji.
Beiji, yeah. Plenty, yeah. Alright. Okay, so it's okay, no problem. How would you say that? Mei guan qi, mei guan qi. All right, let's go. Zuo ba, good. Zuo ba, the light tone there. Zuo ba, good. Zuo, or you can just say zuo. Okay, sorry. Dui bu qi, dui bu qi. I'm sorry. Good morning. Zhao an, or you can just say zhao. Alright? So, questions. When you're learning a language, it's good to ask questions. Now, some of these we've learned already, but some of them we haven't yet, and they're very, I think I found them very, very useful. So, the first one you guys already know. What's this? How would you say this? Very good. Ni hao ma. Good. Light tone. Ni hao ma. Alright. Or sometimes I hear people just say hao ma. They don't even add that ni. But ni hao ma is how are you. Alright. Where are you going?
Go back to the first one. Sometimes they just say ni hao.
Yeah.
Ni hao is hi.
Yeah, it's just hi. Yeah, ni hao. Ni hao. Yeah. Yeah, so when you greet someone, usually just say ni hao, just hi. But if you want to know like how they're doing and stuff, you make it into like a question form. Yeah, the ma in ni hao ma. Alright. Okay. Whenever I would like meet someone, when I'd want to practice my Chinese and I'd meet someone and want to ask them a question but I didn't know what to say, I would almost always just ask them this, where are you going? Yeah. So, where are you going? You say, ni. Yao. So, you want, ni yao. Chu. Chu. So, chu, what would chu mean?
Go.
Chu means go, we're going. Ni yao chu. Nali. Nali. Alright? Nali is where? Now there's not, Chinese grammar is pretty basic, pretty simple. And people tell me that you can just put, there's not much structure to Chinese grammar, you can put words anywhere you want. But I know one rule that is, whenever you're using the word like, words like where, what, who, it's always at the end of the sentence instead of the beginning. This is, you want to go where? That's how you would ask. Where are you going in Chinese? Ni yao. Ni yao chu na li. Alright.
Ni yao chu na li.
Yes, good. Ni yao chu na li.
Can you say,
ni zai na li? Yes. Ni zai na li is where are you? Yeah, where are you? I think that might be, is that on here? Oh, no, it's not. Yeah, that's a good sentence to learn.
Where are you?
Where are you? Yes.
We can put that on the what do you want to learn section.
Oh, what do you want to learn section. Yeah.
And if you're lost, you can say, 我在哪里?
Where am I, yes.
Where am I? Or something, I say, I'm lost.
Okay, I'm lost. 我. What tone is me?
Me.
Second tone?
Second.
Me. Lu. Well, mi lu means lost. Mi lu. La. Mi lu is lost. Then you just add a le at the end. So, 我迷 means yourself. 迷路, 迷路 means lost. So then you can ask, 我要去哪里? Where should I go? Where am I going? Yes, 你要去哪里? 我要去哪里?
Could you tell me, what was that first one again? 你, so.
This one?
No, up above. The
phrase. Oh, yeah, this means. Yeah, it means where are you? Where are you? Yes, 你在哪里? 我迷路了. Yes, I'm lost. Yes, I think someone mentions before, if you're lost and they say, oh, just go to 7-Eleven, that usually doesn't help because there's many 7-Elevens. Yeah. All right. How much is it? We learned this yesterday. How would you say it? 多少钱? 钱 is money, so you don't even have to say money at the end. 多少? 这个, this, 这个多少? 这个多少? Alright, I heard my friend told me that whenever you go to a different country, this is the number one sentence you need to learn. It's the most important sentence in every language. 厕所 is bathroom. 厕所 在哪里? So you have the 在哪里 over here again. So where is 在哪里? And you just add, remember the where needs to be at the end of the sentence? Say at the beginning, just add 厕所 is bathroom. So you can use this for many different things. 学校在哪里? School, where's the school? 我家在哪里? My house. Where's my house? 家. Yeah. Yeah. Good. 我家. 我家 is country. Where's my country? Yeah. Yes. All right. And how would you say?
Would you just repeat it again?
Oh, sure. No problem. 厕所. 厕. The C is the this sound, like the TS, 厕所, like an S-W-O, 厕所在哪里? All right. So, how do you say 7-Eleven in Chinese? They just say 7. If you ask, I hear people, even those that can't speak English, I never hear them say 7. They just say 7. Just say 7. 我要去7. I'm going to 7-Eleven. So you just need to hear 7. Yeah. That's right. Everyone just says 7, right? Yeah. Or 7-Eleven.
We also say 小七, small 7.
Really?
Yeah. Oh.
Okay. Really? I never heard that.
小七 is popular recently because of the soap opera. Do you know the two-timer? How do you call the two-timer? 小三, or someone who has an affair, right? Or say 小三. So the third person will call third. Remember third, three. So we say 小三, that means the third person. Someone who interfere others' marriage or relationship, we call that 小三. Then it's kind of like joking. When you mention 7-Eleven, you just say 小七. That's just kind of joking. 小.
Wow.
小 is kind of like
to bring a close.
respectful 微笑
Okay, yeah. So you can, if everyone asks if you learn in Chinese class, you can say, you know how to say? Xiao san, zi dou fu, zi fang. Cao fang, yeah. Alright. Okay, so. What time is it? What time is it? You say, 现在现在现在 is now. So if you're going to say this sentence, you know, sometimes you don't even need to say these two words. 现在现在 now. 几点几点 is what time is it?
You just have to say it is.
Okay, it is good. You can say
the
time.Yeah, you don't have to say it is. You just say 7. Okay, 7 o'clock. Like
九点.
九 is 9. And 点. Do you just say the number? 九点半. 半 is half. So
9:30.
Yeah. If you want to say 9:34, you'd say 九点. You say 9. 九点三十 is 35. You can say fun at the end. So you say the like 9, then you say the end. And you say like 35, fun.
We just say 九点三十五, we don't have fun.
Oh, but like the correct end. Yeah, so then you don't even have to say the fun is minutes.
Oh, formal.
Formal.
Kindergarten students, elementary students, okay. 现在是9:35, then you will say 现在是.
Okay.
So that when we teach English, we ask them to say in the whole sentence.
Okay, we'll keep it easy. We don't want information overload. Yeah. All right. So, let me...Let's see, if we have time at the end, I'll teach you how to count 1 through 10. And, yes, so, and, yeah, so just for all the stuff I'm teaching you, I don't expect anyone to remember everything by the end of this week. I think if you can remember most of what's taught, I think, like, if you practice for the next month or so, just learning these things, you'll be doing very well. All right, so how old are you?Like, G is the same as this one. It just means like how much, like how old. Sui, sui is age. So, ni ji sui. Ni ji sui. How old are you? Ni ji sui. Who gao su ni? I won't tell you. Ni ji sui. Good. How old are you?Alright, this is the longest sentence I'll teach. But it's important. Can you speak English? Alright, 你 is 会. What would 会 mean?
Can.
Good. 会. Can. 你会说. What is 说?Say or speak. Speak and say. Both are 说. 你会说英文。英文 is English. 英文. Good. Then you add the question mark at the end. 你会说英文吗? Good.你会说英文吗? Alright. And if you can't, if someone asks you that, 你会说 Chinese 吗? If you say, no, I can't, you just need to use this can and add 不 at the beginning. 不会. Like, I can't. 不会. can't. Alright? Next one, we learned this before. What is this? Very good. 这是什么? 这是什么? Alright? Okay, what are you doing? Good. Alright, you say, 你, you, 在, 在, so it's the same 在 as this, in or at. 你在, 做, 做, 做 is do or doing. 你在做干什么? So 什么 is what? 你在做什么? What are you doing? 你在做什么? Alright. What's your name? Now the for name is in Chinese is 名字. 名字, is this a light tone?
What's your
should be word. The word.
字, what tone?
Fourth. But we
fourth tone?
This should be the fourth tone. But like when we speak, we use the light tone.
Light tone, okay. Alright, so that's name. But when you say what's your name, you don't always have to add that in the sentence. That just makes it longer. So you can say 你叫什么 means that name at the end, but in order to make it simpler, you just say 你叫. 叫 means call or what? Means call or talk. 你叫什么? So what? 你叫什么? What's your name? 你叫什么? Alright? Okay. Who is he or who is she? Alright? She and he are both ta. 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 Si. We learned si before. It means is. Say. Say. Say is who. Ta. Si. Say. Alright. Ta si say. Alright. So let's repeat. Well, let's review one more time. How are you? Ni hao ma. Okay, where are you going? Ni yao chu na li. Very good. How much is it? Duo xiao qian. Good. Where is the bathroom? 厕所在哪里? Alright. What time is it? 现在几点? Good. How old are you? 你几岁? Good. Can you speak English? 你会说英文吗? Good. What is this? 这是什么? What are you doing? 你在做什么? Good. What's your name? 你叫什么? 你叫什么? Good. Who is he? Who is she? 他是谁? 他是谁? Alright, very good. At the end of, after this I have, I wrote down three C's you need to learn, I think is important to learning for Chinese. But I think I won't go over that, so you can just read that sometime. And we have 10 more minutes before the end of our class. So I'm going to teach everyone how to count to 10. Then after that, write down words that you want to learn in Chinese. And then sometime today, you can talk to me or some of the Chinese teachers, and we'll teach you how to say it. So that's, yes.
You should also teach them how to say, I don't know.
不不 means no 我不知知 the ch has the j sound 知Spell third tone or fourth tone? Fourth tone. 我不知道。Okay, 知道 is no. So if you say I know, I understand. 我知道。But if you don't know, 我不知道。And I don't understand.This one you'll say many, many times. That's what my first year or two, I used this sentence many, many, many times. Well, this is a little different. Teen, teen means listen. Teen, well, teen. Boo. Boo means no.懂 is understand, third tone. 我听不懂 Or you can even skip the teen part. 我不懂 I don't understand. 我听不懂 我听不懂 我不懂 Good. I don't understand. Alright. Okay, does anyone else have any more questions?Alright, so let's learn how to count 1 through 10. Alright, so, and it's also very important that in Chinese, when they count with their fingers, it's different from the US. That's very, very, very important to know. Because if you do this for 6, if you do this, they're thinking 15 or 51. This is not 6 in Taiwan. Yes. So what they do 1.For one, you say E. Very easy, like two E's. E. E. Two. Er. 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 Good. Did I write this down? Let me write it. So, 1 through 10. You have one is E.Second tone. Okay, third tone. Third number three is san. Good, so 1, 2, 3. E, san. 1, 2, 3. Good. Four. Si. Si. All right. In Taiwan, 4 is an unlucky number because of if you change the.Because of si changed to the third tone si, that means die. So if you go to some apartments, they don't have a fourth floor, or the fourth floor is cheaper. So if you want a discount, you can get an apartment on the fourth floor because it's very unlucky. If you go on a plane, I think some planes they don't have a fourth row.
The hospital
too. Yes. Good.
Oh, they,
but I remember I had a friend in Taipei, and they got an apartment on the fourth floor, and it was discount. It was cheaper.
But not anymore, because everything in Taipei is the price of the money. So, if you don't care about the fourth, they even think it's a lucky number. But it's so in hospital. You have kind of, this hospital, you know, superstitious.
Yeah. Yes. Okay, good. So, four, si, si, si.Alright, 5. 5. Third tone, right?
5.
5. Okay, like two O's, like a double O sound. 5. 5. Okay, so E.
5.
3. 4. 5. 5. Alright. So, oh yeah, when you count with fingers, 1, 2, 5.1 through 5 is the same thing. E, 三, 四, 五. Now 6 is when it gets different. You do this. This is 6. Leo.
Leo.
Just like the name. Leo.
Leo.
Leo, like L-E-O. Then you go fourth tone. Leo.
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 Leo. Seven. First tone. Chi. So this is six. Leo. This is chi. So Leo. Chi. Alright. Then eight. Ba. So you go this six. Leo. Chi. Ba. Now nine would be this. You do that. Or do it. Jill. Jill is their term. It's also the same sound for liquor or wine. Jill. A Jill. Drink. Liquor. So, Leo. Chi. Ba. Jill. Jiho. Shi. Now 10, they make a cross sound. They make a cross with their fingers. 10. Because the character for 10 in Chinese, yeah, is this, yeah, just the cross or a plus sign, yeah. Shi. Good, so Leo. Chi. Ba. Yo. Shi. Alright. Okay, let's try it one more time. Ready? One. Yi. Er. San. Si. Wu. Liu. Chi. Ba. Yo. Shi. Alright? Alright, very good. Okay? Our
also, when I was, in the beginning, when I was writing words on the board, the students got really confused because in the U.S. we write T plus. And they would stop and write Y. They were really confused. So
I got don't understand this. You have to add a tail.
Yeah.
Yes.
Good.
So you write everything.
No, that's a, we never added the tail, yeah.
Really? Are you first in your ABC?
Of course, yeah, we never added that one. Because we don't know Chinese, we don't know the Chinese characters.
My whole teacher corrected me
in writing
my T.
Yeah.
But check the table.
Check the, yeah.
Check the table, the typing. It's a tail. There's
it's
a tail.
It's okay, my dear. British English has it.
Okay, we're out of time right now, so yeah, if you have any questions about Chinese, yeah, just there's many people who are fluent in Chinese, you can ask them. And just to let you know, if you are interested, starting 2 years ago, yeah, about 2 years ago, I would write like a simple homework page for those who wanted to learn Chinese, like usually 10 vocabulary words or a couple sentences. So if you want to receive those emails from me, just come to the front and yeah, sign this the back of my book, like right here, and I'll send them to you. But if you don't want them, okay, but maybe some of them don't want it. So yeah, because it's very, very easy. So
you don't want anything from Andrew? That's
hurt. It's okay, I won't get hurt. No, it's okay. I don't wanna say anything to you unless you want it. So I won't get hurt. My feelings won't get hurt, I promise. Alright. Just the last thing, I just want to encourage you all, just in learning Chinese, don't be afraid of making mistakes. I've been learning Chinese for over 10 years, and still almost every day people laugh at something I say wrong, or and everything, something I say wrong or mispronouncing a word, and that's just a part of the process. It's just important not, just realize everyone makes mistakes. I know, like, the biggest one mistake that I have that my Chinese teacher likes to tell everyone is that I told you before, like, whenever I go to small Kemen, my co-teacher would actually grab my hand and pull me on to the boat. And so during Chinese class, we're learning about the word boat. She wanted everyone to make a sentence with the word boat. And so I wanted to tell my teacher that I said, when I go to small Kinmen, my teacher pulls me onto the boat. Now, boat in Chinese is?
Chuan.
C-H-U-A-N. Chuan. Chuan goes up. But there's another word that's very similar to it. Chuan. And that means bed. So I guess you can guess what I end up saying. And my Chinese teacher is also the pastor's wife. But she thought it was hilarious that almost all the foreigners that come to Kim and learn Chinese from her, and she likes to tell them all that story. So yeah, I've got a reputation over there. But anyway, just don't, everyone makes mistakes. And when you do, just don't give up, just keep on practicing. So anyway, I think you all do great. I think you can learn a lot of Chinese this. No, I don't have time. It's break time. It's in the PowerPoint in the book you can read. Alright. So we'll now take a 10-minute break, and when we come back, Anita, who's sitting in the back, will teach us about classroom management. Alright.